Good morning. It is like 6:30 in the morning and we are going foraging. I haven't been foraging in a hot minute, probably like a month and a half, which is really sad. So let's make the most of these last few weeks of spring and go to get a ton of amazing plants. So this here is California Bay Laurel. It is awesome for headaches, especially if you crush them fresh like this and give them a big sniff. It's really great for that. You can also dry them, take them home and heat them and simmer them over a pot and then inhale those vapors, and it also really helps with headaches and migraines, things like that. So I'm going to take a few of these leaves home with me. So this here is Cowboy Cologne. I'm not gonna pick any because I have talked about it on this channel before. It's really great for pain management. You can drink it as a tea for period cramps. You can make it into a salve, so like a balm to use for any muscle aches, but also things like arthritis. It actually works really, really well. Like I said, already foraged some, so not gonna take any today, but in case you're wondering, that is California Sagebrush. Alrighty, so this is an entire field of wild oat straw. Wild oats are really great as a mild sedative, something to calm your anxiety and your stress. You would drink it usually as a tea instead of a tincture at the end of the day, similarly like you would with a chamomile tea. It's super easy to identify because you've got these seed pods that hang straight down and dangle like that. These can get pretty tall. If we've had a wet spring, you can actually get these to like, I think like 6 feet tall. So these ones are a little shorter here, but perfect for gathering. The parts that you want to use are either the seed pods and the oat straw itself. So these leaves that we have on the end, we just need to pull those off. So I'm gonna gather quite a bit of this because I love having this in my apothecary. Thank you. as with most wild grains that we have, the stalk is usually hollow. I don't know if you can tell on camera, but it is hollow in the middle once I break that. These are not toxic, so you don't have to worry about that. I think the only caveat there is, although they are gluten-free, if you have a gluten intolerance, sometimes these can grow with other plants that do have gluten, so you should be careful. So all these leaves here, we want to pull off. You can do that at home later too. So we don't want that. We just want the stem, and we can keep the seed pods as well. You can gather these fresh or once they've already yellowed and dried out, like these are here. And as per usual, right on the side of the dirt path is pineapple weed. Pineapple weed is a relative of chamomile and it can be used in a lot of similar ways, so it's a mild sedative. Today there seems to be a theme of wild sedatives. The oat straw also makes a really nice evening drink. I actually like the taste of the pineapple weed in my tea better than chamomile. It has this like little zing to it at the end. You can actually eat it fresh, just like this. Quite good as well. Has that little bit of like a pineapple citrusy type of flavor at the end of it, but otherwise quite a mild flavor. Excellent little trail snack. I saw a recipe for these anti-anxiety type cookies that use fresh pineapple weeds, so I'm going to do that as well as dry a bunch for teas. It's only 9 a.m. and it's so hot with the sun already. It's just in these fields on the top of the hills. There's like no refuge save for one of these big oak trees in the middle. So I'm hiding out and resting a little bit. I was hoping to get more California poppies. Unfortunately, it seems like I'm a little bit late. I do have some growing in the garden, so hopefully that'll be enough to make a nice tincture. I also had these grand plans of getting some miner's lettuce for my lunch. Clearly way too late for that. Miner's lettuce comes out very early in spring. It's a delicious like forest green, very mild, similar like a spinach, but no such luck. Everything was dehydrated at this point and dead. But that is kind of what foraging is about. Sometimes you have these grand plans and nature says, sorry, no, there's none of that available for you.